I would cry over pastries. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can tell from the title, I'm going to be doing the reading 200 pages a day for 1 week challenge, except I'm in a kind of reading slump. I have no desire to pick up a book right now. So this challenge is gonna be me getting out of this slump. The last couple books that I'm not putting the blame on, but I'm semi-pointing fingers at, is the Inheritance Game series, because that series was just so good that I binged all of it, and I just have no desire to pick up a book right now. And I don't know what it is. So I'm gonna be doing this challenge that you've probably seen over BookTube, except I'm kind of in a reading slump. So let's see how this goes. It's also gonna low-key, like, not force me into reading more, but like kind of force me to make time for reading, because I find myself sitting at a screen for like 15 hours a day, and I just like, I can't do that. So I need to be able to take breaks, which I feel like this challenge will help me just take breaks and read. Overall, this will be helpful to get me out of my reading slump and get me, I don't know, taking breaks from my screen, because I'm on my screen way too much. So let's pick out a book. However, I think I know what I want to read. I'm in between two books. Let me go get the other one that I want to read. My recent read was You Again by Kate Goldbeck. I'm still not out of my slump. I was talking to my friend, and she has been in a reading slump since, I think, April, and she said that this book is very get me out of my slump, and she's been loving it. She said that it's actually getting her out of her slump, and she feels so good reading it. So, and that is Wildfire by Hannah Grace. She also wrote Icebreaker, which was really good, just as a nice enemies to lovers book. It was just like an easy read to just get through. So I'm hoping Wildfire is the same. I don't know if I want to read this first, because I also got the ARC for Caught Up by Liz Tomford, and I loved The Right Move. Caught Up is the third book in the Windy City series, and I only read the second one, The Right Move. I've heard mixed feelings about Mile High, so I just went straight to The Right Move, and honestly, like, you can read them alone, I'm pretty sure. So I got the ARC for Caught Up, which is on my Kindle, so I really want to read that so that I can get a review up before the release date, because the release date, I think, is on Monday, so I want to read that and get a review up on my Booksta. Definitely my feelings are gonna be in here, but this video won't be done, so you guys will be seeing this probably, I think, a couple weeks after release date. I don't know, I'm like, which one do I pick? Okay, I think I'm gonna read Caught Up. I think it's a single dad nanny trope, and I just recently read Heartless, and that was really good. I really like that book, so I'm hoping that Caught Up gets me out of this little rut that I have, and hopefully I can read a fantasy or I can get into Wildfire. I really want to read that, and I really want to vlog it, so I thought, why not today? I'll update you guys when I end up reading.
Do you know that Taylor Swift song?
Stop!
You know that Taylor Swift song that goes, it says that Taylor's dead?
Taylor really can't answer the phone. Caught Up, and I just, like, I don't have any words. I enjoyed every second of that book. I did not want to put that book down. I just wanted to keep reading, and I finished it last night. So Friday, I didn't update Saturday, but Friday I read 240 pages, so we completed the 200, went over it a little bit. Wow, I look crusty, I'm so sorry. Anyways, and then Saturday I read 269 pages, and that finished off Caught Up. I'm obsessed. We completed the challenge Friday and Saturday. Today's Sunday, so let's see if we can get that done. I'm pretty sure I will because I have some stuff to do, but a lot of it isn't due until like during the week, so I'm just gonna try to get caught up. I didn't mean to get caught up on schoolwork. Why am I? That was so stupid. I need to get caught up on schoolwork, so I'm just gonna try to do as much as I can today. I'm not gonna stress myself out over it because I like technically don't really have that much to do. Wait, I just remembered. So again, I don't want to stress myself out because I don't want to stress myself out. But Caught Up. I'm obsessed. I cannot believe I got the arc, first of all, and I got to read it. I just got so giggly and like smiley about it, and who would have known that I would cry over pastries? Pastries! I literally cried over tiramisu. Like, are you serious? I'm not gonna say why, but I cried over pastries. I also, when I first started reading it, I didn't realize it was Coach's daughter. I thought it was just like a random nanny that he found and like fell in love with. But it's Coach's daughter? I can't stop giggling. And like, I could not stop laughing at their banner and at their like remarks to each other because they both equally did it to each other. And I love that because it just kept going back and forth. And I'm like, I love this. I love you. I love everything. I just loved how they were so respectful of each other and like respected each other's boundaries. Sometimes some of the rules didn't apply. Can I just say, everything that went down that made me just kind of like turned red in the face went down in Boston. Where I live? Are you serious right now? Are you serious, Liz? Are you serious? You did this to me? Everything that went down that should have went down in Boston. Liz was like describing the neighborhood and she was like saying how it's like Boston's little version of Little Italy, and I'm like, yeah, exactly. I'm like, Liz, when did you come here? I have no words. Everything's happening in Boston. Why is everything happening in Boston? So now I'm gonna walk around the North End and be like, this is where Kai and Miller went. I knew exactly where they went. And I was like, oh. I was like, okay. And then they left Boston, but still. I'm just so smiley about it, and it was just such a good book. I have no complaints about it. I love The Right Move. That was like one of my favorite books. Literally, I have it right here to annotate, and it's one of my favorite books because something about Ryan and Indy, something about them, which so many of the previous characters show up in Caught Up. I love them. Isaiah, Kai's brother, he's hilarious. He's silly. He's so silly. He's just so unserious. And I really do love it. I really do love it. And I'm probably not gonna stop thinking about it. Indy and Ryan make such a huge comeback into this. And I'm like, they're part of everything. I'm like, I love you. I just want to wrap this book in a hug. Kai is the sweetest human ever. Miller's going through this little career crisis because real. And Kai... the things he does to just help her through it. Malachi, why? I couldn't put the book down. Seriously, I couldn't even film because I just wanted to keep going. It's so good, so good. You guys have to read it. I hope it's out by the time this is out, but you have to read it. I think it's out by the time that this is out, but you guys have to read it. I think if you guys like The Right Move, you might like Caught Up. But basically the tropes, you've got Coach's daughter, you've got nanny, single dad, you've got a little bit of Grumpy Sunshine, a little bit. And Max, he's the cutest. Oh, let's pick out our new book. I can't talk about him no longer. So we've got my handy dandy TBR cart. I'm not sure what I'm feeling. I was feeling Wildfire a lot. It's been so cold these past days that I'm really feeling fantasy, and I feel like I know which one I wanna pick. This one I feel like will be next. I don't know. I'm like, do I go for a thriller? Do I go for All the Dangerous Things? I'm like so happy though, because I feel like Caught Up definitely put me back into like a I feel everything, I want to read. I don't think I was in a reading slump. I think I was leading into a reading slump, so I needed a good book. I've heard really good things about Heartless by Marissa Meyer. I kind of really want to read this. All the Dangerous Things is looking really appealing to me right now. Or I could do Red Rising, but that's what I'm feeling right now. I don't know why, but I was like really excited to read this, but I feel like I just want to read this right now. I don't know, I really don't know why. It's just intriguing me. We're gonna go with Stacey Willingham, All the Dangerous Things. Yeah, why not? Next might be Wildfire, because I'm like, I like keep looking at it and I'm like, I kinda wanna read it. I'm not gonna start reading this because I have a couple things to do, but I'm definitely gonna start reading it today. I have to, because I have to complete 200 pages. I just realized I didn't like tell you guys what this is about, but pretty much it's about this mom whose son goes missing after he gets taken one night. And then she starts getting interviewed by a crime podcaster or something like that. I think it like makes her second guess like that night that he was taken, her childhood, like everything, but she's like determined to find out who took her son, what happened, and like what's going on. So this is really interesting. Let's see how it goes. It's already Thursday. It's like 9 p.m. on Thursday. I've read nothing. I haven't updated since I think Monday. A couple of updates for you. Already failed the challenge. And I've been starting a new routine that I'm trying to get like in. So that's been a little bit hard. And I've just been so unmotivated and I just don't want to do anything. When I have a lot of work, I'm just like, I'll do it tomorrow. And then I end up piling it on until I literally have everything to do in one day. That's great. And I'm just so tired. But I have a couple updates for you. Wow. I think the last time I updated you guys was on Sunday. Because I haven't talked too much in this vlog, I think I'm gonna extend this into end of Sunday. So we're gonna do like a week and a couple days. So Friday and Saturday, for a recap, we did 240 pages, 269 pages, did the challenge. Sunday, I did 212 pages. So that whole weekend was a success. Monday, however, was when it starts going down. Monday, I only did 108 pages. Tuesday, I did 76 pages. Wednesday, I did 104 pages. And today, I've done none, but I'm about to go read a little bit. And I'm currently reading Wildfire by Hannah Grace. It's her newest release. Came out in the beginning of the month. Monday, I finished All the Dangerous Things by Stacey Willingham, which I should probably put this back on. But I think I rated this like 3 stars. I don't know, like it was kind of, I don't know, I just like, I enjoyed it, but I wasn't like spooked out. It was more of a mystery to me, and I feel like it's advertised more as a thriller, which is really not how it is portrayed. It has a lot to do with motherhood and like the thoughts that a mother has, and even like after birth and after pregnancy and all these thoughts that come flooding in someone's head. So it was a lot about motherhood, and it was more of a mystery rather than a thriller. So I think that's why I kind of gave it a 3 stars, because I was kind of like not misled, kind of went into it like thinking something else and thinking like I was gonna be spooked. And so I don't know, expectations were okay. Not my favorite thriller, not my favorite mystery, but yeah, it was just good. It was a quick read. It was under 300, I think. So I finished that on Monday, and then I picked up Wildfire on Tuesday. This is so good. I'm like halfway already. I'm obsessed. It's literally, I love this because I'm in my senior year of college, and so he's the goalie in the Maple Hills hockey team, which Nate from the first book, Icebreaker, is from. This is Aurora. She is a student at Maple Hills, and you know, Russ's team has a big party, and Aurora goes, and she ends up hooking up with Russ that night. But she ends up sneaking away, and so they don't talk about it. They don't see each other until the next day when they're both camp counselors. Oh, it's so It's just like funny because it's like college life. It's literally the epitome of college life. It's just so much fun reading about college students and I love it. I love it. I am surprised because Russ is, I thought Aurora would be like the shy introverted one, but Russ is. This is really interesting because I kind of like forgot what Russ was like in Icebreakers. So I like forgot that he was very shy and introverted and I love Russ. I love it. I love him. I am literally obsessed with him. They both have daddy issues. So that's fun to read about and that's fun to see them bond about. I don't know. I'm really liking it. I'm 179 pages into this, so I think almost halfway. I really want to finish this. This is so good. So good. And I cannot wait until they give in because right now Russ is still following the rules of the camp and everyone's catching on to them and I'm just like but yeah, so I'm gonna be doing this until Sunday, so it's gonna be a Friday to Sunday thing. And I also failed a lot of these days, but that's okay. I'm not like being super hard on myself because 200 pages is a lot. If you're like super busy and you like need to make time for everything, it can be a lot. Like that's 2.5 hours, 3 hours of reading every day. So I'm just glad I got to read a little bit every day and I'm happy with it. We failed another challenge, but I'm happy with it. Yeah, this is a fun challenge so far. I like seeing how many times I can get 200 plus. I think it's been since like Wednesday. It's Monday. It's quite literally the next week. Is it really a reading challenge of mine if it's not chaotic, if it's not a mess, if it's not failed? I just failed another challenge, but whatever. I read at least this week, so I'm just... It was such a chaotic week, I'll be honest, and I am low-key in a little reading slump, so I don't even want to think about books. I don't know. It took a little bit. It took some effort. We did read 3 books this week, which doesn't really make it seem like I'm in slump, but I just like took me a lot to like think about reading. Okay, let me just recap this entire week, how many pages I read. Only successfully done this challenge for 3 days, which was the first weekend, so Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then we started the week back up with Monday 108 pages, Tuesday 76 pages, Wednesday 104 pages, Thursday 0, Friday 17 pages, Saturday 118 pages, and Sunday yesterday 68 pages. But that's okay. I ended up reading anyways, and that's kind of what this challenge was for, just to get me to read because I did not want to pick up a book. So a success, but not in the way it should be. But I'm gonna redo this eventually when I have more time. I'm probably gonna redo my 24-hour video too because I want to get that too. And I want to reach my Goodreads goal, so I have to do that. Caught Up was so good. I think it was like 4.5. It was so good. I didn't want to put it down. I really did not want to put it down, and that's where my like successful 200 pages were. And then the fact that like a majority of it took part in Boston, I was like... Second book was All the Dangerous Things by Stacey Willingham. This was on my October TBR, so got that off my TBR. I don't really have too many thoughts about it. I can't remember if I talked about it in the other like update recap that I did. I don't have feelings towards it. I wasn't like spooked. I wasn't like, oh my god, big plot twist. It was good. It was interesting. I want a book that spooks me. I literally need it. I need to read Freda McFadden because I've heard her books are really spooky and I kind of want to do a video on it. Maybe I should. And then the last book we read was Wildfire by Hannah Grace. This is the second book in the Maple Hills series. I ate it up. I was like, are they gonna get caught? This the time they're gonna get caught? Nope. Next time? I don't know. I need to know what happens when they get caught because they're sneaking around. The summer camp has this like no fraternizing, what is it called? Fraternizing, I don't know, between the staff and stuff. So they're sneaking around. I literally, at first, I was like, why does he kind of look like Joe Alwyn? And why does she kind of look like Taylor Swift? And then there were some Travis Kelce, Taylor Swift developments, so I was like, no, we're switching face cards. He's Travis Kelce, she's Taylor Swift. It was funny because in the book there were like friendship bracelets involved, and there's like talk about being a famous person and being in the eyes of the media, and like sometimes how you don't want to put that pressure on people that you know because you're famous and like the other person isn't, and I don't know. I can't tell. I think I like this book more than Stacy and Nate's. I typically don't like cute baby names or like cute like relationship names, but I, when he was calling her sweetheart, like it feels like an old guy nickname, you know what I mean? But it just fit them. And he is so charming and gentlemanly, and so I love Russ Kelly. But that's it for this video. I think I'm just gonna end it off here. I'm not gonna try to do more days and try to, you know, do any more 200 pages, success, fail, you know. I'm just gonna end it here because it's been a chaotic week. As we've seen, I did not successfully do this challenge. We're gonna redo it again. I do have another reading vlog that I'm really excited for. I'm hoping my books get here in time because I ordered them from the UK for this video, and I literally hope this video and these books get me out of this reading slump. Ugh, I don't even know what book I'm gonna pick up next. I just like look at my TBR and I'm just like, I don't know what to pick, and there's so many good books. That being said, this is the end of this video. Thank you for coming along with me for reading 200 pages a day with me. I hope you guys enjoyed, even though it was not a success. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you stick around for more videos, and I will see you in the next one.